Hi guys! In this video, I will introduce the Xcrafts Open Beta program, and I will show you how our customers can get early access to new versions of our products. Before we release any version officially, we first need to beta test our latest updates, and our customers now have the possibility to try these out before they are released. Please note that with the beta versions, we are essentially sharing our work in progress versions, so it is possible that you will experience issues or even crashes. So only use the beta versions if you are comfortable with this. Luckily, the Skunkcrafts updater makes it very easy for you to backroll to the last stable version, or in other words, the version that is currently in the store. The main purpose of us giving you access to our beta versions is so that we can get feedback from a larger group of people and make sure that our products are as stable as possible when we release them officially. It is therefore extremely important that you always give us your feedback. After a day or two of beta testing, please come to our website or our open beta topics on the forums and answer this one question. Can we release this version, or did anything significant stop you from finishing a flight? If you were able to complete your flight without any major issues, please submit your positive feedback by clicking on one of the three buttons, depending on your operating system. If you ran into some major issues, for example, X-plane crashed, the autopilot did not follow the route, the FMS did not load the flight plan correctly, or your computer combusted into flames, please submit your issue in the bug report on our website or in our forums, and make sure to always include your log files. This will give us a good idea whether or not our products are ready to be released. Alright, now let me show you how you can get our latest beta version using the Skunkcrafts updater. First of all, make sure to download the standalone version of the Skunkcrafts updater. The standalone version is much faster than the in-game plugin version. You can read all the installation instructions and usage guidelines on our website. You will learn how to install the plugins as well as how to use them. We have specific instructions for both the standalone version as well as the in-game plugin version. And if you haven't yet, make sure to download our free handbook, X-plane Explained. It is aimed at total beginners as well as seasoned pros, and it will definitely elevate your experience with X-plane. Once you have the updater open, you will see that the products that have the beta versions available will have an indication in front of the name. Prod stands for production version, so the current version that is in the store, or it will say beta, which means that the product is currently using the beta versions. If your product does not show either of those, it is likely missing the Skunkcrafts updater beta config file. You can fix that by using the updater itself. Just check for available updates and then click Update or Repair Add-on, and it should download that file for you. Now let's click on the product that we want to update for beta. Under Extra Info, click on Enable Beta Channel. Press on Check Available Updates. If a beta version is available, you should see the name right there. If there are no beta versions available, it will tell you that all files are up to date. Click on Update and Repair Add-on and wait until the status shows all files successfully updated or repaired. Now click on Reload Configuration and confirm that the version now shows the correct beta version. Next, you will load the plane and X-plane. You will activate it and then reload and confirm that the version pop-up that comes up when you load the aircraft shows the correct beta version. And that's it. Now you're flying our latest beta version. By the way, if you're ever wondering what version of the aircraft you're using but you don't want to reload the plane, you can always click in this section right here next to the PFD and it will show you the current versions of each element of the plane. And you can see that the first on the list is the aircraft version, which is what you're interested in. Next, let me show you how you can go back to the production version if, for example, the beta version is causing any issues. Open the Skunkcrafts updater again, click on that product, and disable the beta channel. Check for available updates and you should see the production version available. Click on Update and Repair Add-on and you will see that it's downloading back all those previous files and overriding the beta files. Okay, all done. So if we click on reload configuration, we can confirm that we're back to the production version. And as a final step, we'll open the plane in X-Plane. We will again reactivate and reload the aircraft, and then we can check on the pop-up that we are back to the correct version.
Hey, before you go, I would love to ask you something. Do you ever wonder how we create these digital planes that you fly on a daily basis? Why is the sim crashing sometimes? Or why is the performance of some add-ons much worse than others? These and many more topics are all part of our Not a newsletter. If you join our community, you will learn all about it. Plus, you will be able to tell us directly how we can improve your flight sim experience. So make sure to get your first Not a newsletter by signing up below.